Hi and welcome to the breakdown on ThePapare.com, where we look back at week three of the Singers School's rugby season. It was an outstanding weekend once again. Let's start with Trinity versus DSNNIC Sabir, 65 points to nil. Trinity scoring 11 tries, but only three of those came before the half. It was only 22-0 at halftime. Tries coming from Ayesh Edrisinghe, who scored two. Shalinda Alahakon, who scored two. Dinushka Dange, Sanushka Abevikrama, Sanjana Sangasinghe, Pasan Samaravikrama, Charit Nanayakkara, Amit Kulatunga, and Kanisha Dialvis with conversions from Thisula Karnath, Pereira 2, Sanushka 1, and Lashan 2. So, what do you make of that two halves difference?
Yes, Shanika, the very first half, very first 15 minutes, DS gave a real heart attack for Trinity. They were dominating, but their place kicking for Ashraf Moose made terrible kick, two penalty kicks which went astray, and also they missed one more penalty kick. But I think in the second half, Shanaka, probably the bench players did more impact than the players actually who started. Mm. Especially, I like the half-back combination in the second half between Boyogoda and Lashan Vijayasurya. They pretty much played like the Conor Murray and Jonathan Sexton type of game. Whereas Tusila Pereira, he was a little bit slow, but perhaps his weight will be needed for the next game to play along with St. Thomas's. So, two different half, I think. It took a little bit time in the second half to get settled and work through the faces and work through quick hands between the backs.
Yeah, I think Coach Eric Miller would probably have been using this game to just check which of his halfback combinations is the more deadly one. And Ayesh Edrisinghe, a pretty impressive game for him as well.
Yeah, very good to see. Two tries and also the centre combination also very good on that occasion, Shanaka. They were also making some yards. So, good signs. Even Coach Laga was watching. Again, Coach Marty's watching. So, good signs for Trinity, but they can't be complacent with this win.
Yeah, it definitely can't be, but 65 points to nil takes some doing. So they are putting themselves in the driver's seat ahead of the big match for the Cannon Irish Desserum Trophy against St. Thomas's. But then we had a very close game as well at CRNFC the day after. Sabir St. Joseph's versus Wesley. It was 19-10 in favour of Wesley College at the end of it. 7-0 to the winners at half-time. What did you make of that game?
Yeah, actually, you were in the commentary box, Shanaka, but that game, of course, Wesley was winning a deserved win after two very close loss for them. But even again, St. Joseph, they had the momentum building up. Only three players I saw playing their fly half, Charit Chaturasenaviratna. He's just kicking, but he's not playing the running game. Perhaps that needs to be worked on.
Yeah, that's something that they need to do. But the tries coming for St. Joseph's, Vinul Fernando, one try. Devon Fernando had an outstanding game, another try. And for the Wesleyites, it was Avishka Lee with one try, Oshan Dias and Dimindu Vimukti who scored the final try at the end of that game, with Avishka Lee putting over two conversions as well. But both teams can play a bit better, I think, Sabir. This was probably St. Joseph's best game of the season so far.
Yes, without a doubt, if you look at the score margin as well. And also, not forgetting the Wesley's number 8, Shanaki, was used in the lineouts to winning. And also, their four-man lineout, that is quite a lot, positive for the Wesleyites rather than going the 8-man lineout. And also not forgetting the scrum off, Avishka Lee, he's so quick. So probably I think he's the best defensive scrum off rather than attacking scrum off.
Well, not sure about that quite yet, Sabir, but I think Sashek Fernando, the number 8, had an outstanding game. I think this guy is one for the future that we need to look at. But then in segment 1A, we had the biggest match that everyone was expecting so far in this school season. Royal taking on St. Thomas's, ending 21 points to 15 in favour of the Thomians. But at halftime, Royal were leading by 10 points to 7. What an outstanding game of rugby and what a finish.
Yeah, it is. Nail-biting finish. It's a disappointment finish for Royal because it was clear evidence that we saw their backs are not as good as any other backs in that segment.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was Hamza Riza who scored both tries for Royal, and he scored it at the back of that brilliant rolling maul that they execute. Ovin Askey, one penalty and one conversion for him. And for St. Thomas, it was a complete opposite. It was a winger scoring the tries. Navin Henakan Kanamge scoring two, and Ashwanta Herath, one try and three conversions to take St. Thomas's on to the 21 points. And it was the final move of the game, Sabir. I don't know if you noticed it, but it was actually set for a number eight break. You could see Vijayaratna was prepared for a number eight break, but the ball came out from between his legs, and it was Dhanoj De Silva who had nothing else to do but just run onto the blind side, and luckily he did that for the Thomians, because that's what gave Hainakang Kanam gave the ball.
He's the man, Hainakang Kanam. If he got the ball like few more times in the game, they should have won at least by pretty much a 10 points in the margin, Shanaka. But he just got twice and he scored twice, so that's a good sign. But talking about the Royal Mall, Shanaka, what a strength they have. I think referee Ishat Kada also missed that when Pasindu Amar Singh caught the ball in the air, and he was holding the ball and moving forward. The ball didn't go into the channel as a result, but Kada was giving a penalty for St. Thomas.
Yeah, I think that was the one call that Kada got wrong. I thought he had a very good day apart from that, but that one call he got a little bit wrong, because you could see Pasindu holding the ball up later and saying, "Sir, I had the ball."
Yeah.
And what St. Thomas can do in that situation is that they can go and chop tackle the ball carrier. And that's the danger of that particular move, because you're putting your ball carrier, you're exposing his rear to quite a bit of an attack. But I think that the rule needs to be applied properly, and I think Kada may have to go back, look at the video. It's very difficult to miss whether the ball has actually gone back to the back row or whether it's still with the man in the front. So that was one area where they need to figure it out. But I think Royal's Mall, it's pretty much unstoppable, Sabi. There's just absolutely nothing St. Thomas's could do to try and counter it. Where they needed to counter it was try and contest the line out and try and put some pressure on Reza, who was throwing the ball in. But unfortunately, it's such a cruel game, because their lineouts had been functioning so well. The final lineout that they absolutely needed to win, they lost the ball, and that's what conceded the try at the other end.
Exactly. I was quite surprised, Shanaka, because tight five, St. Thomas tight five, comparing to the weights of the opposite team, they had pretty much 35 to 40 kg in extra. I thought, in fact, they were going to contest the lineout and they should drive it into the lineout, but it didn't happen. They didn't want to get involved in the lineout. But on the other hand, Shanaka, it's clear, but you never know whether the lifter is holding the ball or is sending the ball inside the channel. This is where the assistant referee's call should come into place.
Yeah, absolutely. There needs to be some interaction between the assistant referee and the referee, because the referee is probably on the infield side and the assistant referee can see from the other side where the ball actually is. So there needs to be constant communication there as well. But you're right, for St. Thomas's, they've got the weight advantage. But watching that match, you could see the body positions in trying to contain that maul were not good. They were far too upright, and despite having the weight, if you don't have the right technique going in there, then it's not going to be helpful. And I think they kept trying the same thing, which is where Pandula De Silva, the captain, should have been able to try something else when he realized this wasn't working.
Yeah, of course. And also, we cannot forget the game Ashok Vijaykumar played. It's a clear difference from fly half to scrum half. He moved, and then he just controlled the entire game, sadly, the last minute.
Yeah, I thought it was inspired that he actually moved into the scrum half position last year. And then now they're moving him to fly half and moving him to scrum half in the second half. So you can see that there's a clear difference in the way he plays in both those positions. And when you need territory, you use him at the fly half berth. When you need to control your forwards, you use him in the scrum half berth. So Coach Martis really identifies those players, knows how to use them in their best possible positions. But Royal, I think, need to keep the oppositions guessing a little bit. They need to give Trinity a few things to think about. They need to show them that they can do something out wide as well. Otherwise, you're just going to be concentrating on this one thing. And then it becomes easy now that Coach Miller has seen how devastating the mall can be. I'm sure he's going to be working purely on that.
And especially in the first half, number 13 center, Janindu Dilshan of Royal College, he didn't let St. Thomas fullback Mayan Jayawardena to move away. He came three rush tackles Mayan on his spot, so that's a good tactic in terms of defending the St. Thomas line.
Well, that's something that I think Royal built their game on, Sabir. It was built on two things. It was built on the rolling maul, and it was built on an outstanding rush defense. And that's exactly what they managed to execute brilliantly. I thought Dilshan was good. I thought Lennox was good at number 12 as well. He held his line while he allowed Dilshan to shoot out of the line, so he was always covering in case the man mixed. So that discipline that they showed in defense was really good. But sometimes you need to have just a little bit more of an edge to be able to turn the ball over and run that back at the opposition. So that's something I thought Royal were a little bit lacking in. But in terms of defense, they really were outstanding in the centers. But as we know, the tackle on Hainakam Kanangwe should have been made, and that was something that was missed. But also Bhumindra Dissanayak at the Thomian fly half, I was quite surprised that he didn't notice how quickly Dilshan was flying up in defense. All he needed to do was chip the ball over the top or grubber the ball at an angle for Hena Kankanange to run onto, and then you've got real problems behind.
Yes, that did not happen. So it'll be interesting for St. Thomas when they go to Nithavala. In fact, Pallakali next week, Shanaka. And let's have a look at the segment 1A points table.
Looking pretty decent for St. Thomas's at the moment. 3-1, and same for Trinity. 3-1, so that's going to change when it comes to next weekend. 16 points apiece. Royal now suffering the one very close, cruel defeat almost. 11 points that they have out of their three games. Wesley managing to register their first win this weekend so far, and they've got 8 points. St. Joseph's and DS are the two teams who don't have points from any wins. They've just got the bonus points, so 3 points each for both of those teams.
Looking at the next weekend fixtures, Shanaka, St. Joseph's hosting Royal College at CRNFC, Trinity versus St. Thomas at Pallakkal, and Wesley College versus DS in predictions.
Well, St. Joseph's versus Royal is going to be closer than people imagine, Sabir. I think Royal will go to that tried and tested formula, but St. Joseph's will have the confidence knowing that they almost beat Royal last year. They will know that they have got what it takes, the game plan that it takes, so they can execute that game plan again and see if it works this time around. So Coach Bilal Yusuf knows exactly what this Royal College team is like, so it'll be coming up against his old school, so I'm sure there'll be an added spice to that encounter. But if they can get the ball into the hands of guys like Ramesh Priyankara and Gamanu Chetia and Vinul Fernando, then the defense is going to be tested out wide. Trinity versus St. Thomas's, that's going to be too close to call, Sabir. St. Thomas's will be really cock-a-hoop after that close win, but Trinity with that big win against DS playing up in Pallakkale, I think that might be a little closer than people expect as well. I would love a St. Thomas's win, but I think Trinity College might just pull that one off. And Wesley versus DS is probably going to be a win for Wesley, but they will have to play well. They need to use this particular game as one going forward against the likes of St. Thomas's. If they want to make an upset win, they need to use this particular game to get their combinations right.
Yes, indeed. Wesley also should look at gaining a bonus point when scoring 4 tries. So those are the analysis for the segment 1A of Singer Schools Rugby League. Do join us for the segment 1B.